Hi everyone, it's Janis here with a new episode to help you build better daily structure and be in control of your life. There are common misconceptions out there that if something is not working, then you should simply try harder. Often, however, your brain just needs more fuel and rewards to keep going. Today, we'll take a look at the book called Your Brain at Work by David Rock to learn how your brain works and how to maximize its potential. If this is your first time on this channel, then make sure you subscribe and hit the bell icon to get updates on my latest videos about time management and productivity. The problem with the brain is that it gets tired very quickly. And once your brain is tired, it is easily distractible. So we forget about our priorities and instead waste our precious time. The following strategies will help you to work more optimally so that you can use your full potential and become more productive. So let's dive in. Number one, don't waste your mental energy. Your ability to think and make decisions is a limited resource, so you have to think in ways how you can preserve this energy at every opportunity. Let's talk about our everyday nutrition and how this applies to it. We all need to eat food in order to survive. That means that we have to do shopping to buy all the ingredients and then cook our meals. If we don't approach this process in a structured way, we will use a lot of our energy. We will constantly have to make decisions about what meals we will cook and what ingredients we will have to buy. And doing that in an unstructured way will burn a lot of our time and energy. The way around it is to pre-plan your meals and do batch cooking so that you don't have to worry about all these tiny decisions. If you want to learn how I spend 5.5 hours a week on a cooking, then make sure you check out my video about how to streamline cooking process. I will link the video in the cards and in the description below. Number two, remove internal distractions. We often hear that everyone is blaming smartphones and social media as the biggest distraction of our time. But before we make any judgments, let's take a look from a different perspective. If it was all down to our smartphones and social media, then we could simply switch off our phones and work undistracted. But that is unfortunately not the case. Yes, it is true that sometimes you get a notification on your smart device and that gets you distracted. But even more often, distractions start from within your head. Your brain is constantly consumed with thinking about new things and also trying to remember them. This in turn uses a lot of brain processing power, and after some time, your brain gets overwhelmed. At this point, you don't need your smartphone to distract you because you'll be reaching for it by yourself to get some relief. So you need a strategy that helps you to deal with your internal feelings and overwhelm. Luckily, we don't need any expensive tools and complex systems. All you need to do is to constantly write down your thoughts and ideas to free your brain's processing capacity. Number three, how to trigger optimal brain's performance. Two major factors that play an important role in order for our brain to function with optimal performance are rewards and urgency. Let's start with urgency. When there is no urgency, then you're not likely to perform well. So how can you create urgency in your life? It's simple. You simply have to set deadlines for your tasks. You probably know that feeling when you're working on something for a long time and it seems like you're never going to complete it. And then your boss tells you that you have 2 days to complete it and somehow, magically, you get it done. Was it a miracle? Not really. You simply had a deadline and urgency behind your actions. Next is rewards. Reward is an interesting thing, especially for your brain. Your brain loves rewards because rewards are triggering dopamine, hormone that is associated with pleasure. This is why it is so easy to fall for a prey to habits like eating unhealthy foods, simply because we love the taste of them. So you got to think about how you can attach rewards to the things that you want to achieve, and that will trick your brain into working harder for you. For example, I remember when I set myself a goal to get in shape. I also booked a photo shoot session in advance, so I knew that I have to be in my best possible shape. This was my reward because I wanted to get some pictures with myself in a great physical condition, and also it gave me urgency because my photo shoot was pre-booked in advance. Number 4, master control to increase your brain power. How do you feel when you have more work than you can handle? And how do you feel when somebody else is telling you how to approach your daily tasks? If you are like most people, then you will feel discouraged and unmotivated because you're not in control of the situation. Your brain will also respond in a similar way, and instead of using its full capacity, it will slowly and unwillingly do its functions. Brain scans reveal that when we are in control over the situation, we experience the strong sense of rewards. Research shows that we are less stressed when we are facing a challenging situation that we have control over, compared to similar situation where we don't have control. So how do you put yourself in control? It starts with controlling your time. Make a plan for a day, and then achieve everything that you plan to do. You can even start smaller and make a plan for next 60 minutes. Pick the task and focus on it until it's done. This will instantly make you feel better and activate your brain. Number 5, manage your expectations. Do you ever really get excited about something that you think will happen, just to be disappointed a few minutes later? Maybe you think that your job interview went so well that you started to tell your friends that the job is yours, just to find out later that they selected another candidate. Or maybe you just felt that job promotion is yours, but later felt destroyed after your colleague got it. Setting expectations for the things that haven't happened yet is a trap. To avoid these kind of situations, you have to manage your expectations by not allowing yourself to get emotionally attached. Even if you feel that you're the best candidate for promotion, just keep working as normal and celebrate only when it's officially announced. So how about you? What strategies do you use to get the best out of your brain? Let me know in the comments below. I hope that this video gave you a fresh perspective on how brain works based on a certain stimuli and how you can influence it to achieve better results. If you enjoyed this video, then make sure you hit that like button. And if you have any questions about time management and becoming more productive, then leave them in the comments section below. If you enjoyed this video and you're interested in productivity and time management, then check out my free Mastermind coaching program, where I teach my complete productivity framework, starting from setting out a vision and then breaking it down into goals, projects, and actionables. It's a live coaching environment where I do consistent live coaching videos as well as Q&A sessions, so you can ask me questions and get instant answers. Join now and take your productivity to the next level. I'm looking forward to seeing you inside.